Hello, my dears. This is Sarah from SheHoldsDearly.com, and today I'm so excited because I finally get to take you on the tour of the master bedroom. We have been working on it for so long, and I finally, for the first time since I've lived here, feel like it is complete and I don't have to think about it for many more years. So let's get started. I'm going to show you some befores as I'm going through this. And then I also made a mood board a while back and things have totally changed, but I will show you that as well. The other thing that I want to tell you before we delve into our reveal is that there are many, many tutorials and videos that are linked to this room. And I'm not gonna go into a ton of detail on every little thing in here, because if you're interested in that particular tutorial, you can head over and actually learn more about it that way. But there will be a lot of links in the description below for all the details, all the things, and some links to products as well. So when we first walk in the door, we see my husband's armoire. This is what he uses instead of a dresser. I got this free from my husband's grandma and painted it in a chalk paint, and then the inside is this yummy different gray contrast that I really love. It's worked out great. I love the height of it. I love the size was perfect. It was just awesome to get it for free. Then we have an old closet area that you come to. Now this room used to be two rooms. I'm told that the back half of the room was the original owner's, his wife's sewing room. So when whoever took the wall out and made this a large room, when they did that, it created three closets, which I kind of love. So we don't even need this closet area that I'm sitting in right here. I turned it into my office space and it's worked fine. I did have to find a desk that was small enough to actually fit in the space because it is a little tight, but other than that, it was no big deal. We shiplapped it. I can show you the video for that. And then the desk, I ended up doing what is called color washing. And so this is black, so it's black washing. Any color you use, you say that and then washing. And it's just a chalk paint that I wiped off with a wet rag and made these nice smeared areas that just give it a lot more of a like watercolor feel. So there's a tutorial on that. Then as we swing around, we see the bed. Now I had moved, we had a big sleigh bed on the other end of the room, and I ended up taking that out and just getting something that had a lot more airflow and light flow, and I got this wrought iron bed, which people love, and I will link this for you. Once we got that figured out, that's what we're gonna do, then I ended up doing the double layered dust ruffle on here. I got my bedding from IKEA and the thrift store, most of it, and then made the three pillows in the back, the Euro pillows. I made the ticking pillow for the lumbar pillow, and then I got the two lamps at a garage sale and dyed the shades black. I found the one nightstand that doesn't have the drawer. I found that at an antique store, and then the other one I had from a while. Actually, no, I got the other one from the same antique store, but it was like 10 years ago. And I painted that one with the Miss Mustard Seed Boxwood Milk Paint. And so there is a tutorial for that. And then the last thing about the bedding area is that I just very recently remade this brass chandelier. Now, I think that brass is very much on its way back, especially hammered brass. So if you see that, you know, in the thrift stores and things, grab it. I think we are about to hold on to hammered brass for the next 10 years. But the shape of the chandelier just needed, it needed to feel not from the 80s, more of what's been going on with the vintage look. So I tried to get a like raw wood look, and I have a tutorial on that. And I literally hot glued crystals on that I bought from Amazon. Then we move around, we swing around, and now we're focusing on the two closet areas that we actually do use as closets. So one of them's mine, one of them is my husband. We got these bifold doors off of Craigslist, and I really love the shaker style look. And so we just added on the little boards and then painted them the same color as the armoire. And I actually used some old knobs that I had, so it wasn't too big of an expense. But I really love how they turned out. They're soft and they are kind of feel custom and built in. So then we swing around, we have, well, these curtains I haven't mentioned, but these were IKEA curtains that a lot of IKEA's white curtains have a yellow undertone to them. So I tried my darndest. I went through many products and I could not get them perfectly white until I used a product made by OxiClean. And so there's a whole tutorial on that. People love that tutorial. But so I got them pure white and then I stitched on the one edge. I bought some tassel trim. So I really am happy with how the curtains look in this room. They're new compared to what we were coming from originally when I really started to focus on this room. And then I recently as well showed you the reveal of my husband's office area now that he's working from home. And the table was super fun makeover. I literally, you guys, was ready to either burn the table, literally, in the fire pit, or I was gonna give it a chance and I was going to try to create this faux concrete top by using a board with some trim and painting this product on there that I got from Poland. I love it. I'm so, so glad that I gave it a chance. And it became his desk and he loves it too. So more information on how to make anything look like concrete. Oh, that's a great tutorial. Check that out. Check that out if you are interested. Okay, and then we're swinging around. I did just a quick makeover for this mirror. I painted it with black chalk paint just to kind of tone down the, had a real Tuscany feel to it with like gold and browns on it. So I just calmed it down, made it look kind of French. The chairs, people love the chairs. They are tufted slipper chairs. If you are just in the market for just gonna buy this style, that's what you're gonna look for. They're called tufted slipper chairs. I found mine at a garage sale. I gave them makeovers years ago, and I will link that. I wasn't on YouTube at that point, but I'll link the tutorial, the blog post for that. And then the mantle, there are actually three videos and three blog posts that match that one because it has gone through quite the transformation and used to be dark and had these big corbels on it. I got it off Craigslist and I kept tweaking it and changing it, and I've got it now where I really love it. It looks very French to me, and you would never know that I pulled this thing off Craigslist. The marble on there is just contact paper, and nobody knows except for you now. But no one can just walk in the room and know that that's contact paper. So the final little spot is we're back to the door area, and I took another Craigslist piece. I think originally it was a pier one, like an end table type thing. I wanted to turn it into a faux card catalog, and I feel good about how it turned out and how we remade the faces of it to make it look like little drawers, and I bought the little pulls to put on there. Actually, that is where I got my knobs that I put over on the closet area. And then I added some great big casters that I got off Etsy. So there's a really cool tutorial on that. And then the bulletin board up above it was a knockoff from something that I loved on Ballard Designs. And I made it in like less than an hour. So that is a beautiful piece that I recommend for, like, you know, wall decoration. And it just so happened that my linen matches perfectly with my mantle and with my closet doors. So yay, love it when that works out. So that's it, we are done for a while. I am getting ready to give it a holiday look in here. But other than that, I am not gonna worry about the master bedroom for a long time. I'm gonna turn my focus to probably the kitchen, the porches, and the laundry room. So you can be looking forward to that in 2021. Otherwise, that's a wrap for this room. Thanks you guys for holding on and being patient as I like took forever to get this room wrapped up. But sometimes it goes like that. And I'm okay with you guys seeing that, that that's very normal when you're living in a space and you keep tweaking things. And I actually, as much as it frustrates me that it takes me so long to get a room finished, I do believe that the DIY lifestyle really gives you the opportunity to make things look incredibly customized and just like a work of art. And if you didn't have the time and you weren't living in the space, I don't know that it would look as personalized and just have that beautiful, beautiful custom touch that you can bring to it over time. So, all right, thanks you guys so much for watching and hanging out at the farmhouse again. If you're new here, please consider hitting that subscribe button. I do post regularly and I share my professional design advice for the DIY home life. All right, take care. I'll talk to you soon.